The Intel Arc A750 has been making waves in the budget gaming market since its launch in October 2022, thanks to its amazing value and performance. But how much has it improved with the latest drivers? And is it still worth buying in 2023? That's what we're going to find out today. We're not going to waste your time with the specs or overclocking results on this card. You can check out our previous review on that. What we're going to do is compare the launch driver and the latest driver, which is version 3.1.0.101 something something. Seriously, Intel, can you make your driver names more user-friendly? We're going to run this card through our usual suite of benchmarks, including 10 popular games, 3DMark, TimeSpy, Port Royale, and some Adobe Suite tests in PugetBench. We'll also show you how this card performs in terms of power consumption and efficiency and value. Our test system consists of a Ryzen 5800X3D CPU, 32GB of 3600MHz RAM, and an Asus X570P motherboard. All the details are on screen right now, so buckle up and get ready for some juicy data. This is the Intel Arc A750 launch driver versus the latest driver. Let's go. Let's start with the rasterization performance at 1080p. The Arc A750's driver shows a solid improvement in most games. In some titles like CSGO and Rainbow Six Siege, it even delivers a massive boost in performance with the latest driver. This means that Intel has done a great job in optimizing the drivers, which is evident not only in the high average FPS, but also the smoother 1.1% loads. A good example of this is in Rainbow Six Siege, where the difference is huge. However, not all games that we tested saw such a benefit. Any DX12 title like Spider-Man, Forza, F1, and Cyberpunk only had a slight increase in performance, as they were probably already well optimized for Arc. But hey, we're not complaining. Every frame counts, right? This brings us to the average FPS for 1080p, where the FPS increased by a pretty impressive 26%. That's a decent overall improvement that puts the A750 closer to a 6650 XT and 3060, instead of trading blows with the old and dusty 1650 Super with the old driver. But more importantly, the gaming experience was much smoother with higher 1.1% loads, which honestly make all the difference. Trust me, you don't want to play Cyberpunk when it's lagging and stuttering. It's not fun. Moving on to rasterized games at 1440p, where the story is pretty much the same as 1080p, but with some differences. The gap between the drivers narrows a bit in some games like CSGO and Spider-Man, but it delivers a decent improvement in performance with the latest driver. It's not as noticeable as 1080p, but it's still there. You can also see which games are already optimized for Arc, as they start to perform almost the same with both drivers. However, the newer driver still offers slightly more consistent experience, with higher 1.1% loads once again. Again, looking at the 1440p averages, we can see the improvement is not as impressive as 1080p, as we only saw a 15% increase in performance. But hey, that's still better than nothing, right? Looking at the overall average for both 1080p and 1440p, we see a respectable 21% increase in performance. That's not a huge increase, but it's still pretty good. It's mainly dragged down by the 1440p performance, which was not as impressive as 1080p. Now looking at the performance per dollar, you can see the Arc A750 used to lag behind the 6650 XT, but now with the improved drivers, it's able to beat the value king 6650 XT. That's a remarkable 21% increase in value. Take that, AMD. Despite the better performance, the Arc A750's power only increases by around 4%, which means it's a lot more efficient. That's confirmed by the significant increase in performance per watt of 17%. That's some good engineering right there. Overall, we can see that the new drivers made a noticeable difference in performance, efficiency, and value on the A750. Intel has done a great job in optimizing their drivers and making their card more competitive. Well done, Intel. You deserve a cookie. Let's move on to the ray tracing performance at 1080p. This is going to be a bit different to rasterization performance because all these games are DX12, which means they were already optimized for Arc, so we're not expecting a huge difference between the drivers. But what's interesting is that the old driver still manages to beat the RX 6650 XT by a large margin in most games, which shows how bad the ray tracing is on AMD. Come on, AMD, step up your game. However, there were a few exceptions like F1 and Spider-Man, where the performance actually improved by a noticeable margin with the new driver. But the overall performance was pretty much the same. This is confirmed by the averages for ray tracing at 1080p, where the performance only increased by a tiny 20%. That's not very impressive, but hey, at least it's better than AMD. Moving on to the ray tracing performance at 1440p, where the story is pretty much the same as 1080p, with some differences. The gap between the drivers narrows significantly, which means that the performance for ray tracing was already pretty good, and there's not much room for improvement. The old A750 driver still manages to beat the 6650 XT in most games, which is still pretty impressive. But hey, that's not saying much considering how bad the 6650 XT is at ray tracing. Looking at the 1440p ray tracing averages reveals a disappointing increase of 9%, which confirms what we saw overall in ray tracing, that the increase is pretty small. But hey, at least it's better than nothing, right? Looking at the average FPS for both 1080p and 1440p in ray tracing, we see a small difference with an increase of 15%, which is consistent with what we saw before. The value also stayed consistent, only increasing by 11%. But what's interesting is that the A750 already had the best performance per dollar of any other GPU, which shows that Arc was pretty well optimized from the get-go. Power consumption also increased by 5%, and despite the small performance increase, the performance per watt increased by 8%, making it a still more efficient card with ray tracing. So overall, we can see that the new driver didn't make a huge difference in ray tracing performance, but it still made the card more competitive and efficient. That's not bad, but we hope Intel can do better in the future. Next up are the benchmarks. Starting with 3D mark times by 1080p, we see the new driver only beating the launch driver by around 7%, which confirms that Arc was already pretty well optimized for DX12, as this is mainly a DX12 benchmark. Moving on to a ray tracing benchmark in 3D mark, which is Port Royal, we see a similar situation, although the newer driver still beats it by a tiny 5%. This again shows that Arc was also pretty well optimized for ray tracing. Moving on to a more productivity focused benchmark, in the Puget Bench Adobe Suite, we see a small performance increase, but still an increase nonetheless. In Premiere Pro, the performance gets a boost of 9%, and in After Effects, there is a small 2% uplift in performance with the new driver. This shows that Arc was also pretty well optimized for these apps, and even the old driver still beats the 6650 XT. So whatever encoders they put in there, they work pretty darn well. To wrap things up, Intel's Arc drivers have come a long way since the launch of the A750 GPU. They have boosted the rasterization performance, making the A750 a more competitive and smooth gaming card. They have also increased the value, making the A750 a more affordable and attractive option. And they have also improved the efficiency, making the A750 a more power-saving and eco-friendly card. The ray tracing performance has seen some minor improvements, but this is still better than the competition. Overall, Intel's Arc drivers have made the A750 a better GPU in every way, making it a great choice for gamers on a budget. Anyways guys, that's all for today. Make sure to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell. Also make sure to check out this video on screen right now.